While appearing before the Finance Committee to present the budget framework paper of the Uganda Revenue Authority for the year 2023-2024, URA indicated that they project to collect 29.78 trillion shillings from both taxes and non-tax revenue, which is contrary to the 28.88 trillion shillings that is quoted in the national BFP. This forced MPs to question the variance.
The tax collection is increasing from 25 to 28 trillion.
The gross domestic revenues are projected at 29.784 trillion, of which tax revenue is 27.775 trillion and non-tax revenue is 2.009 trillion.
As URA anticipates an increment of 3.3 trillion shillings as additional revenue for the next financial year as a result of improvement in tax administration, they decried the hoping 2.88 trillion shillings to be lost in tax exemptions. According to URA Commissioner General John Musinguzi Rujoki, it is continuously affecting the growth of revenue collections.
And a growth of 16.6%, up from 25.55 trillion, which is expected from the current financial year.
The authority also presented a list of 1,810 categories of sectors enjoying tax exemptions, among which include agro-processing 11, charitable organizations 188, deemed VAT 188, SACOs 1,289, among other sectors. To make matters worse, the government has recommended a list of other taxpayers for tax exemption, which include UGACOF, worth 33.942 billion shillings, Uganda Broadcasting Corporations, 10.8 billion shillings, Kanoike Construction Company Limited, 4.909 billion shillings, St. Mary's Hospital Lacho, 282 million shillings, among others.
Up to now, bring to us and justify why these amendments were given, the exemptions, the incentives were given, and if the output which was expected is being achieved. For example, many of our young people are boarding planes. Actually, we have a broad day slavery happening in our very own eyes.
In the midst of the scrutiny, the Commissioner General told the committee that the entity is affected by inadequate workforce as many of its workers continue to leave for greener pastures. MPs, however, questioned why the budget to salaries has been maintained at the same figure for three financial years, yet workers keep leaving the entity.
There is need to review the staff welfare, and we have looked at a minimal staff enhancement, wages enhancement for all the staff, and that will require 162.095 billion.
Still, URA seeks 1 billion shillings for treatment of staff with HIV and COVID-19. Among the unfunded items of URA is 500 million shillings required to fight COVID and another 500 million shillings for the treatment of staff and their families with HIV and AIDS because their insurance covers do not cater for these ailments.
AIDS has an allocation of 500 million. The environment, an allocation of 1 billion. And COVID-19 interventions at 500 million.
URA budget is projected to grow to 567.14 billion shillings, leaving the entity to grapple with a funding gap of 6.438 billion shillings. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.